Hi everyone, welcome back to 45 Degrees Sailing. My name is Nick. We are here at the Beograd Boat Show, 2021 Beograd Boat Show. Now we're currently just outside, seeing behind us everyone is lining up to get into the boat show because of course we're in the COVID world now and you need either your COVID passport that could be scanned at the gate or a PCR test or a rapid test. Now they're doing rapid tests over here. Outside the boat show, you can do that for 50 kuna. So remember, subscribe to the channel if you're not already. Let's head into the boat show. So one of our first stops when in the tent here at the boat show is we've found this company called EcoFlow, and this is
Ivica
from EcoFlow. We're really impressed with this. They're doing mobile charge stations, solar charging, eco-friendly, great products. So tell us.
EcoFlow products you can use in many different ways, and there are different features that there are not competition doesn't have. Mm-hmm. They can be charged in three ways: through solar panels, on electricity, and in your car with the car outlet. And also, they have a 220 outlet.
Yes, so they're inverting to 220 volt power. Okay, so a lot of things do that. Why EcoFlow? Is this environmentally friendly?
It is environmentally friendly. You can use it, for example, a good example would be on a sea if you are on your boat and you don't need the noise that's coming from
the generators. Okay.
And also the diesel or whatever, the fuel that is that is actually not doing good.
Of course. Okay, so solar charging is obviously the future. Not running diesel or anything like that. So we've got these solar panels down here and they fold up into this lovely bag that can come with you, and then they have different sizes of the battery packs and everything. So yes, very sexy packaging. We're going to be giving these guys a call to see what we can use this either on the boat or in the van traveling around. Thank you very much, EcoFlow. So we've just come into one of the Defour yachts. Now, Defour's been one of the yachts the models we've been looking at as possible alternatives when we charter for our trips. Though I've never taken one for one of our 45 degree sailing trips, but this is the Defour 530. Now, this is a four cabin layout, but with a master cabin in the bow, two double cabins at the back here with one bathroom here, ensuite and separate shower in the bow, and a bunk cabin here. The boat, it feels very light and airy. There is a lot of colors going on in here. We've got dark wood on the floor, we've got light wood here, we've got the gray countertops, white cupboards, and there's a very strong... These aren't finished. These don't feel finished. These feel like rough sawn timber, which is a bit strange. So there's a few things in here that I'm not a fan of, and I'd have to really go through the boat to understand how she goes. Though one comment that was just made was that it feels very seagoing with the way all of the cupboards open, the deep wells in them, things to stop falling out, and the latches seem very strong, which is a nice upgrade on some boats. The smell down here is very new, and I've talked about this with a few friends of mine, with the way new boats smell, and some of the newer boats these days are getting a really strong sort of plasticky smell, and I'm really noticing that in this boat today. Though, she's beautiful to look at, and good headroom in here, spacious. I'd be interested to sail on to see how they go, but that is the Defour 530 here at the Beograd Boat Show. All right, so we've just seen that this is a microwave in the corner and it opens the office. That just seems silly. I don't know what happened there. And some of the finishings seem a little bit cheap, and a lot of movement in this woodwork. One thing I've always liked about the Defors is their anchor setup. It's very clean, comes up nicely, and for a note, these fittings here, these bent fittings, help the anchor always come up straight. It's the best system I've seen so far. Also just noticing here, we've got two bimini systems. So we've got a split bimini, but not for a main sheet to come through. I think so that you can still have this cover over the helm stations while you've got the other bimini or dodger down. Great vision through this very clear vertical plastic dodger as well. And because I have trouble on some of the other boats, like some of the smaller Hansas, I'm gonna note it's very easy to walk down the side and get back into the cockpit on this boat. So we're here with Igor at Croatia Yachting, and I want a big shout out to Croatia Yachting and Igor to say thank you, because they invited us to come to the boat show, got us some invitational passes, so sure. We came in, which was great, so
always
thank
glad
you.
To see you.
Excellent, excellent. So, Croatia Yachting, what is Croatia Yachting?
We are basically one of the biggest Croatian charter companies, with bases in Kaštela, Biograd and Dubrovnik. Next year we're opening a base in Seget.
I heard,
in
I
Baltic.
Heard, this is cool.
And on top of that, we are a dealer for all the most innovative brands on the market. So
all of them, I like that.
Hanse Yachts dealer, and then from Hanse Group also Sea Line, Fjord and Rick, which is also a great addition to the Hanse
well,
Group.
I see you've got Lisa and me, the new Sea Line one there,
the
cool.
Sea Line.
And you guys are the biggest Hanse fleet in the world.
And we're also a dealer for Bali catamarans.
So leading into what I was going to ask you next.
Yeah.
We're here at the boat show, there's a lot to see. If we were to see one of your boats today, what is the boat that we should go and see? And
so
why?
One of the newest ones here, and also the one that surpasses the competition the most, is the Bali 4.6.
Okay.
So a really luxurious catamaran with an abundance of living space, which is incomparable to anything else on the market. And it's also the only catamaran of that size that offers a 5-cabin layout, and you'll be able to see that layout here. So it's 5 cabins, all cabins really comfortable, plus 2 skippers' cabins in the front, which are not comfortable, but they're for skippers.
So hey, come on,
that's where
come
you're
on.
Gonna stay.
Yeah, right. That's if I ever get on a catamaran again. Yeah. All right, great. So
but
Bali 4.6.
Check it out. Huge flybridge, as all Bali catamarans, fixed forward deck with a lot of sunbathing area. Huge flybridge, open space with so tilting door that opens the entire
all
salon.
Right, all
so
right.
Definitely check that in motion. Ivan should show you how it works.
All right, we'll definitely do that. Okay, and you know I'm a hard sell on catamarans because I don't like them. So we're going to go over and see the Bali 4.6. Yeah. Thank you again
for
having us. And you get back to selling boats.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.
Wasn't necessarily going to believe him about a comfortable bunk cabin, but he's right. This is a big bunk cabin. It feels really good. The beds, should we check them for length? I think we should check them for length. The width of them looks really good. There's easy access, there's a little ladder, that's cute. Let's check the length. Okay, so I was going to say the bottom one looks longer, so I'll be fair. But actually, no, this one stops here and goes a bit deeper. This one stops here and goes a bit deeper. So I will try the bottom one, but we'll see. Now, as you've seen from previous videos, I'm 6'2", and I'm in. And you know what? That's not bad. That's not terrible. My feet are on the end. My head is not on the end. We've got cupboards down the end for storage here. You know what? That's comfortable, and that is not terrible. That is a good crew cabin. This is shorter, but only by about this much. But I still fit, and I can lie on my side too. Not bad. All right, so cabins-wise, this double cabin that is sharing a main bathroom with the bunk cabin or the crew cabin is a lot smaller than the last two that we just walked through. And yet there's still good headroom here, and there's relatively good turning around space, which is all that's what I'm looking for. Is like, if I was to get changed in here, how much space would I actually have? And that's okay. It's all right. It is a climb up into the bed, but that's all right. Let's check out the bathroom. All right, so the Bali 4.6 open space, I think it's called. I gotta say, it's pretty comfortable. And of course, on the bow, we do away with the nets on traditional catamarans, and we have just full lounging. Like, this is a lounging catamaran. I have not seen a catamaran, especially of this size, with as much space to relax as on here. And as an added bonus, I only just noticed while I was sitting here, is that there's, a very solid bimini top here, which has got LED lights through it, great, and ladder sets so you can get up to a solid section up here to be able to pack your mainsail. One of the problems with the catamarans having such a high boom and high mainsail, I don't think they sail very well. That's kind of irrelevant in these boats. These are a sailing catamaran, you can sail with them, they're great for inside the islands, and they're really comfortable. We've got a huge saloon section up here with a table to eat at or to drink at, and these two lounges out here behind me. I am sitting in ridiculous, I'd fall asleep at this helm because it's so comfortable, and the vision is actually really, really great. So downstairs, I really like how open it is. It feels big, it feels breezy. You've got flow right through from the bow all the way through the back, and this garage door system that they have to either close it down in the wet in the winter or to open it up completely. I really love that. I would definitely be down to review one of these yachts. Hint, hint, Croatia yachting. So, look, the Belgrade Boat Show has been a lot of fun. Thank you for signing on. Remember to hit like on the video and subscribe to the channel if you want to see more of these. Now, if you have any comments or questions about what we've seen here today, or any questions about the boat show in general that I may be able to answer, then drop those into the comments below, or even just say hi. It's great to get these comments from subscribers and viewers. So, thanks a lot for coming. We're going to head off. It's coffee time. I might just take this. The Bali 4.6.
Sorry, I might have gotten that bad.
All right. Beginning. I'll start again.